crazy. I dream of brand new babies. Gazing them days and contagious charm, my baby. We know each other like the back of our hands. Understand, there's no mistake, and I'm taking this from my drive. What's good, YouTube? It's your girl, Asia.
And it's your boy, BJ.
Back in the building.
Back in effect. Back like we never left. And we appreciate y'all for pulling up and hitting that thumbnail. Yeah. Today, as you can see, we're jumping into the Tragically Hip. Yeah. The title of this song is Wheat Kings. So that's what we're going to be dibbling and dabbling into today, trying to, you know what I'm saying, get down into the germs of, you know what I mean?
But first, we have to give a big shout out to Cali by You God. Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining us. Major love, sir. Definitely appreciate it. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any videos from Asia and BJ.
Absolutely. Okay. And here we go. We Kings.
All right.
The Tragically Hip.
Yeah.
Sundown in the Paris of the prairie, wheat kings of all treasures buried. And all you hear are the rusted breezes pushing around the weather vane Jesus. Simple lighter, he sees the killer's face. Maybe it's someone standing in a killer's place. 20 years for nothing, well, that's nothing new. Besides, no one's interested in something you didn't do. We can't. Let's just see what the morning brings. There's a dream he dreams where the high school's dead and start. It's a museum and we're
23 years being at the wrong place at the wrong time.
Can you imagine?
At 16 years old.
16 years old.
Yeah. Wow.
When I tell you that, probably, like, I know for a fact that changed this man's life, like, forever, like, traumatized, okay? PTSD. Like,
yeah, it changes it forever.
In the worst way. You know what I mean? Like, wow.
Yeah.
23 years?
It's almost like somebody taking your life away from you. For something that you didn't even do, and to have to harbor those feelings, knowing that you didn't do something. You didn't do it, and someone convicting you of it, and you know what I mean? That, like, that weighs heavier on somebody's mind,
right.
Shoulders, things of that nature. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, you gotta stand firm and hold on. You know what I mean? If you say you didn't do it, you know what I mean? You gotta hold on to it.
For life,
you gotta stand
though,
on
like
it.
They
gave them life.
Life.
You know what I'm saying?
And they didn't even have credible witnesses.
And with him being in prison, with them saying weak kings, maybe that's him like looking out the window or something of the prison. Because you know, a lot of times when you have these types of facilities, prison facilities, it's in the middle of nowhere.
Right.
So maybe that has something to do with like the weak kings or the weak. Possibly. Like the fields, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We're all locked up in it after dark. The walls are lined all yellow, gray, and sinister. Hung with pictures of our parents, prime minister. We kings and pretty things. Wait and see what the breaking story on the CBC. A nation whispers we always knew that he'd go free. They add you can't be fond of living in the past. If you are, then there's no way that you're gonna last. We hate kings and pretty things. Let's just see what tomorrow brings.
Many others.
Wow.
So this right here at the end was just a lot of other people's names, a lot of other weak kings that, you know, somewhat suffered the same fate or having to go through like the certain types of circumstances. Yeah. You know, and you know I love this song for the simple fact, especially like bringing attention to people that's like wrongly convicted. Mm. You know, obviously we live in a world, we live in a country, you know, where we have a judicial system that's not perfect.
Right.
So a lot of times people do get caught up, you know, and get convicted of crimes that they didn't commit, and then end up spending so much time in prison, their life taken away from their family, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people don't ever get their life back. A lot of people don't ever get exonerated and have an opportunity to like at least be like, you know, come to the realization or can take it to court and actually get it cleared and be exonerated. A lot of people don't. They end up dying in prison on death row, like all kind of things.
Yeah, because they lack the, you know, the resources, the education, they don't know the system. They don't know, you know what I mean? It's just, there's a lot of information that they don't have and they don't have access to
even be able to try to fight
to help themselves. Like, so it's kind of like a, you know, oh well type of situation, but I think that's why Callie wanted us to do this song. Mm-hmm. I'm going to read you this email that he actually said. So, okay. He said the Hips live shows were really amazing. They played everything from giant arenas to outdoor concerts with camping to small dive bars, even when they were famous. When they were famous. I went to dozens of their shows in all kinds of settings. Very intimate to see a big band play in a tiny bar or in Northern Ontario under the constellations at night. At one outdoor concert, a family member of a young man found the band and explained to them the young man had been convicted of a crime he did not commit. They did not commit. And the trial was very unfair. After listening to the story, the band agreed to help and got enough signatures for a petition of the case and raised enough funds for a new defense. The case, the young man was lucky. In 1976, Canada abolished the death penalty. If not for that, he may have never got to see his innocence proven. The man had his conviction overturned, and the band went on to write the song about it. And it's a fan video, but it tells a story, and there's no official video. And so, yeah,
that's a fan video. Okay, yeah, so that gives a lot more context behind it as well.
Oh yeah, and then he said he could have been on a death row, but luckily, only received a life sentence in 1976. Canada abolished the death penalty because other cases had proven innocent people had been put to death.
Mm-hmm.
So, wow.
Right.
Like. Wow. You know what I mean? Like, insane.
Yeah.
Golly, I can't even imagine. Like, can you imagine just, like, doing something, minding your business, just something happens and it's just this crazy out, like, tragedy, and you just happen to be there and somebody saw you standing there and you had nothing to do with nothing. You just was like, huh?
I couldn't imagine what they were feeling.
Oh my gosh. Like, oh, like the rage, like the anger, just how you would like have the disbelief in your own justice system, like in your own country. Like, what type of world have we come to? You know what I mean? Like, just to think that there's nobody that's going to be willing to listen to your truth, to your story, to what really happened. Nor does anybody care. They had to put it on somebody.
Yeah.
Close the case and let's be done with it. Let's move on to the next. You know what I mean?
And they even said it in the song, too, that he's like, nobody's interested in hearing the truth.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, man.
They're not interested in hearing the truth, especially when you have people that's already, you know, they already got it made up in their mind how it's supposed to go, and that they have a person that they're going to make that's guilty, and they're sure of it.
That's so bad.
But I like this piece in her, though, in regards to the Tragically Hip, where they, you know, heard what happened, and you have a lot of people, artists, that, you know, they hear things that's going on, you know, in regards to, like, ground level as far as things that's happening in the community and people, and they don't ever, like, really reach down and reach down to, like, really try to help.
Right.
I like this piece where they actually took the time to, like, go get signatures and put a petition together,
right,
and then actually get funds together to get a whole new defense to help him
fight
his case, because a lot of people don't get that opportunity.
But it's what he probably needed. But then, you know, the fact that they actually were able to prove that innocent people had actually been put on death row and killed, you know what I mean, at that, for that, you know what I mean, and were proven to be innocent, like, after the fact, like,
they've taken innocent people's lives, and after the fact come to find out that they're innocent. So again, that's why it would be a good reason to abolish it, you know, to just do away with it. So if somebody did, like, with same thing with David, Milgard, same thing with him, if that, you know, that law has still been in place, he would, like they say, he wouldn't have the opportunity to fight it later on down the line.
That's,
so,
man,
yeah,
and that, and I just, you know, hey, I commend them for even listening and just trying to do something about it and just help any way that they could. And, and luckily, because that's what it was. Luckily, somebody was able to, like, you know, let their voice be heard and use their platform to the advantage of getting people to you know what I mean?
Yeah,
come together for this whole reason, but. Yeah.
And that's a blessing in itself right there.
Absolutely.
You know, for someone to be able to see what's going on and see the truth of what it is.
That's awful.
And bring it to the light and get an innocent man free.
Right.
But yeah, again, that speaks to the philanthropy in regards to the Tragically Hip, though. But this story is incredible.
Absolutely.
But I wish we could hear more stories like this where a lot of other innocent people can be free. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Agree. Because I'm sure there's a lot. There's still, to this day, a lot. So, if y'all enjoyed this video, be sure you give us a big thumbs up. Like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any videos from Asia MPJ. And if ain't nobody sold you, I love you. And we're going to see y'all in the next video, y'all.
Absolutely. Yeah. Peace and blessings, y'all.
Bye. Lust in your body, boy, I'm addicted. Insisting come